course of the last 2 weeks, two devastating hurricanes have ripped their way through the Caribbean and the southern United States, and a third will be coming for the leftovers. Hurricane Harvey did unspeakable damage to Houston, Irma devastated the Caribbean and Florida, and Maria is going to be the icing on Mother Nature's cake. We are pretty much helpless when it comes to hurricanes, and sometimes we can't prepare for them. It makes you wonder, how do hurricanes form, and how can we predict them? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobre. Don't forget to like and subscribe and let us know in the comments below what topics you would like to see next. Hurricanes are cyclonic storms of the western northern Atlantic. They belong to a family of storms called tropical cyclones. Tropical cyclones rotate around a low pressure center, produce heavy rain, and they have winds of at least 72 miles per hour. Hurricane is the name given to the storms that form in the Atlantic or eastern North Pacific. Similar storms that form in the western North Pacific are dubbed typhoons. Hurricanes form over the ocean in places that have warm water. They grab the warm water energy and pull it into the atmosphere. But you might ask, vapor rises into the atmosphere every day. That's how clouds are formed. What makes a hurricane a hurricane? The thing that makes hurricanes different is they need winds that blow gently high up in the atmosphere, and winds that blow more strongly near the surface of the earth. Here's an analogy. Picture a hurricane like it's a bucket. It needs to stand straight up. If the wind begins to blow stronger high up in the atmosphere, that bucket will topple over. When a thunderstorm forms, it's a result of a lot of vapor that accumulates in the air. This causes the clouds to be heavy, and then it begins to rain. Hurricanes are different from thunderstorms. They need warm water, winds that blow vertically straight inside a hypothetical bucket, and a lot of vapor in the air. The ingredients of a hurricane usually come together off the coast of Africa. A wind will begin to blow in a swirling motion. This is known as a disturbance. When the sea surface temperatures are greater than 26.5 degrees Celsius or 80 degrees Fahrenheit, water vapor condenses and releases heat. That heat rises and creates an inward movement of air. Then that air starts to spiral toward the middle of the disturbance. A thunderstorm begins, creating a tropical depression, and then a tropical storm. More than one thunderstorm will come together, and they will begin to move across the Atlantic Ocean where water is warmer, adding more energy and more vapor. Add the favorable winds and boom, you got a hurricane. The only thing that can stop a hurricane in its tracks when it's over water is a strong wind in the upper atmosphere. The reason why there's been so many hurricanes lately is the end of the summer brings these favorable conditions. So how can we predict hurricanes? Well, the only thing you can somewhat predict accurately is the pathway, not necessarily the intensity. The intensity of a hurricane is erratic and unpredictable. Once hurricanes are cut off from warm water, they weaken rapidly. One thing that is quite disturbing, and perhaps one of the reasons why there have been so many hurricanes this season, is rising sea temperatures caused by global warming. When the sea temperatures rise due to a warmer climate, it will create more hurricanes and also prolong them. But that's still up for debate. Global climate models, which study how the atmosphere behaves over hundreds of miles, aren't able to show much about hurricanes. But as technology improves, so will our ability to represent hurricanes accurately with models. That is all for this LBQ. Make sure you like and subscribe to Life's Biggest Questions for all of life's biggest answers.